Hello, I'm Edu from Edu4Java, and this is the Android tutorial number 4. We are going to see user interface using drag and drop. Okay, we're going to start creating a new project. New project, Android project. We're going to put project name. Android tutorial 4, application name, Android tutorial, that is the is a human readable name, package name edu.edu4java android tutorial 4. The activity we are going to call form, because we are going to make an activity with a form for a book, where we are going to put the title of the book, the author, the ISBN, that is the number, this, and min SDK we are going to use 7, because I want to try later this application in my phone. I have a HTC Desire, and I have the version Android 2.1. Okay, let's see main XML. The main scheme XML, we already saw this file, is auto-generated. But what we did not see is this. Here we can see our components in a visual way. Hello World form can be modified from here. We can select it, this text view, we can select it and go to this, we can go to the view properties and modify the properties of this text view. You can see here this view, maybe you have not this view, you just go to Windows, show view and other, and find in general you can find the properties window. It's a standard window from Eclipse. Maybe the window appear in another place and you just drag and drop and put where you want. Okay, we select hello the text view, and we can go through all the properties of this component. Okay, now we can see this is the screen. We can change the screen. I will try to put a screen like the one that I have in my phone. Yes, I think maybe it's HVGA. Yes, this one could be okay. And I'm going to put in portrait. That is the normal way I work with my phone. Okay, now, if you remember, Hello World Front is the text that is in my text view, my component. Let's try to change it. We go to property and we can look up for the text field. Okay. Here it is. As you can see, say at string slash hello. This means that it's a resource that take from strings XML. Yes, here we can see hello. We are going to put a new string. We can put click here and this window appear, and new string. I'm going to use add new book as a key for the string that is going to appear in the component. I'm going to put the string in Spanish. Agregar un nuevo libro, that is the same that add new string. Okay, as you can see here, agregar un nuevo libro. This is the key, add a new book, and agregar un nuevo libro. Okay. we can change another properties. Yes, we're going to change the size, because this is a little teeny. Yes, let's look for text size 25 SP. I think it's going to be okay. Let's check. SP is like pixel, but it's not absolutely like pixel, it's relative to the size of the screen. Okay, now I'm maybe bold is style, text style. I'm going to put a text style in bold. Yes, I like it. Yes, yes. And now I'm going to try to put this in the center, because yes, better is a title, better in the center. I'm looking for gravity center. Here, okay. And now I have what I was looking for. Okay, now to build the form we need labels and boxes. Boxes where we can put text. Okay, for the label there is a component, text view. Yes, text view is for label. And for autocomplete text view, this could be okay for to put text. This is like a text box, but is auto-completed by the phone. Help me to complete it. Yes, if you have a phone with Android, you know what I'm talking about. We need no text in the text box, because we are going to put the text. Here we have a problem. We need the label and the box in the same line. And what happened here? Control Shift F. Give me this. Then I can see that the linear layout have an orientation vertical. Then the text, all that is inside, is ordered one and the bottom and the bottom. Yeah, I can solve this putting a new layout, but this time horizontal. A layout inside the vertical layout. I'm going to put a horizontal layout inside the vertical layout. And in this linear layout, I'm going to put these two components inside. Yeah, but it's not inside. I can see that nothing changed. Let's see the XML to see what happened. Here you can see, again, Control Shift F. You can see that linear layout is at the same level that text view. Here you can see again the first linear layout and the second linear layout. If we select this, one of these, and click here, we put this component inside the linear layout. Now if I Control Shift F again, you see these two are inside. And now we get the effect that we were looking for. Okay, let's change the label. The property of the label. The properties. The ID, we don't need ID for the label, because we don't expect to use it. And text. In the text we are going to put a new string. This is going to be the title, and for the title we are going to put título in Spanish. Okay, and yeah, a little the size, it's a little style ball, and size we can put 20. Yes, it's okay, 20. Let's see padding is going to give me a distance between the components. I have to put 5 SP. I always forget the SP. Okay, then I have some distance between title and the box. Yeah, it's better. And the box, I'm going to give some width. Let's try with 500. Okay. Seems okay. Maybe. Okay. Then we have one line that is okay. We are going to copy this and paste here and here for the author and for the EISBN. Okay, text, we are going to create a new string, author, with autor in Spanish. Okay, and ISBN, a new string, ISBN. I don't know if this needs translation, but okay, anyway, we are going to put as a resource. Here all the boxes are not in a line. We can put a fixed size, fixed width for title, author, and ISBN. Then we are going to get width, we are going to put 70. Again SP. Okay, and for author the same, 70 SP, and ISBN. Okay, now we have in a line. Okay, button. I want to put two buttons in the same line. Then a linear layout with an horizontal orientation is okay. I put the layout. Now one button, another button. Okay, again, the buttons are not inside the layout. Then with this arrow I put them inside. Okay, I'm going to change. I don't need the ID because I'm going to use the onClick property. In text I'm going to put, for this I'm going to put cancel. In Spanish, cancelar. And for the order, I'm going to put a new string. Okay, no, better add. Yes. No, add. And the string agregar. Okay. Okay. Maybe the width could be better. I'm going to change. Yeah, maybe layout width. We can change this one and put something like, yes, 100. Looks okay. No, 10 is not okay. I've committed a mistake here. Okay. Okay, then we get the form. Oh, here I forget the SP again. For sure in this one, yeah. Again, I forget it. And in the third, for sure. Again. Okay, this tutorial is finished. See you in the next one.